The nearly 100% increase in the monthly grocery discounts for the elderly and the vulnerable sector could be implemented as early as Monday. This was announced by the Philippine Trade Department after House Speaker Martin Romualdez called for the increase of such discounts from 260 pesos to 500. The concession only covers basic goods and items consumed daily, such as rice, meat, and vegetables. Ahead of its implementation, a supermarkets group warns the prices of goods could rise by up to 3%, harming small businesses.
Sa tingin ko, ang business kasi naman forward-looking yan eh. Kaya sa tingin ko, ang mga tindahan, mga retailer, meron na yung plano, no? Naghahanda na rin yan sa karagdagang pagtaas ng presyo na kailangan gawin, oras na maging approved na o kaya nilabas na yung IRR, Implementing Rules and Regulation. Tansya ko mga siguro to mga 2-3%. Ito nga malalaki na chain operation, maaring sa kanila, ano lang yan, okay lang yan, kaya natin yan. Pero pagdating sa micro, small and medium enterprises, yan ang malaking katanungan. Kasi sa kahit tingnan mo yung micro, small and medium enterprises, 99%. Micro, small and medium enterprise. Pero ilang porsyento ng small and micro ang micro, small and medium enterprises? And 99% ulit.
Philippine lawmaker insists President Marcos should take over the National Food Authority as it deals with another corruption scandal. Agri Party List Representative Wilbert Lee says even if Marcos is no longer the Agriculture Secretary, he is still the best person to address the issue. He adds Marcos can help the Office of the Ombudsman speed up the investigation.
With all due respect to the Secretary, there are issues, there are things that if we want the whole of government approach to happen, it's only the President with all the power vested in him. No? So again, for me, it's the President himself who should be the one to head and start the cleansing of the agency of the NFA. And we have also heard that the Ombudsman are having a hard time getting documents from NFA. So if it's the President who's on top of this, then I think nobody can say that, okay, and nobody there would dare to delay or to not submit or anything that the Ombudsman would ask for.
Over 100 officials and employees of the NFA were placed under preventive suspension, forcing the closure of some rice warehouses. The suspension stemmed from allegations the NFA illegally sold 75,000 sacks of rice to favored traders without going through proper bidding. Lee now says both the NFA's mandate and rice disposal process should be reviewed.
If we have rice for disposal, then we have to, I think, make it clear what should be the process, though. Because as of now, there are no circulars, no memos. There's no clear policy regarding the disposals. That's why nagkakaroon po ng mga ganito pong issue.
Philippine provinces experiencing drought and now at 37. State Weather Bureau Pag-asa says parts of Luzon and Visayas, including Metro Manila, are now experiencing below normal rainfall. Meanwhile, another 22 areas are under a dry spell and 12 more are experiencing dry conditions. The agricultural damage to El Nino hit areas also climbed to 1.75 billion pesos as of last week. Pag-asa says while the impact of the weather phenomenon could last through May, below normal rains might continue throughout the rainy season.
Ang first impact po kasi ng developing La Nina or ongoing La Nina at first stage is yung higher probability of below normal rainfall condition during our habagat seasons.
The water allocation given to concessionaires Maynilad and Manila Water will be extended until the first half of April. The National Water Resources Board says it will maintain the current 50 cubic meters per second allocation only until April 15. But beginning April 16, the water allocation will decrease to 48 CMS. The board says the move aims to preserve the remaining water supply until the end of the El Nino phenomenon. But it notes the allocation can still change depending on the water level of Angat Dam.
May projections po kasi kami hanggang May tungkol dyan para ma-preserve lang po natin at maiayos natin ang pagbigay ng tubig sa, especially sa buong Metro Manila.
Isa lang po magiging pakiusap ko sa ating mga kababayan, tulong-tulong po tayong mag-conserve ng tubig.
Maynilad also warns of possible water interruptions if the allocation cut will take effect. Some tourist spots in the province of Cebu also reeling from the effects of El Nino. Annie Perez now joins us with details. Annie, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, that's right. The local government of Oslob has ordered a temporary closure on its famous Tumalog Fault because of the ongoing dry spell as an effect of the El Nino phenomenon. Mayor Ronald Guaren said the closure started last Tuesday, March 19, since there is little to no water coming out of the waterfalls. They noticed this since January that the flow of water decreased due to the intense heat. The LGU also decided to close it because some tourists are expressing their dismay that they do not see the curtain-like waterfalls anymore, even if there is no entrance fee. The area is also far from the main highway. Mayor Guaren said a rehabilitation is underway to increase water capacity despite weather conditions. In the meantime, the LGU said tourists can still check out their other attractions, such as the whale shark watching in Barangay Tanawan and the Sumilon Sandbar. The provincial government is yet to also check if other waterfalls in the province are experiencing the same. Pag-asa Visayas, meanwhile, said that the ongoing dry spell in Cebu will continue until next month, April. However, it will also start to weaken. And that's the latest here in Cebu. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
From over in Davao, activities in Mount Apo suspended because of El Nino. Hernel Tokmo now joins us with that story. Hernel, over to you.
Carmina, trekking activities to the country's highest peak, Mount Apo, are temporarily suspended for 10 days amid the ongoing El Nino phenomenon. The Department of Environment and Natural Resources in the Davao region announced on Wednesday that the temporary suspension of Mount Apo climb began yesterday, March 20, up to March 30, 2024. The decision was made pursuant to Mount Apo Natural Park Protected Area Management Board Executive Committee Resolution Number 1, Series of 2024, enacted a day before the implementation of the suspension. The DENR Davao said that the ongoing El Nino phenomenon has led to a prolonged dry spell affecting the trekking and camping sites within Mount Apo Natural Park. Therefore, they need to prioritize the safety of the visitors and the environment. The agency stated that this is a precautionary measure that is essential to mitigate the risk of bushfires and to ensure the well-being of the park's ecosystems. The length of the suspension was carefully considered based on assessments and recommendations provided by the Mount Apo Natural Park Protected Area Management Office of both Davao and Cotabato regions. The DENR Davao hopes for understanding and cooperation from mountaineers, trekkers, mountain guides, and porters who may have scheduled their climb during this period. For those who made reservations during the affected dates, the DENR asked them to reach out to their respective local organizers to arrange alternative schedules for their excursions. In March 2016, a massive forest fire occurred in Mount Apo during a Holy Week climb where hundreds of trekkers ascended the mountain in various trails. Reporting from Davao, Hernal Tokmo, ABS-CBN News.